In conjunction with National Photography Month, our gallery is featuring three photo-related exhibitions. We've got Sans Camera Exploring Photograms by Mike Kittrell, Quarantine Diaries by the CameraSouth Photography Club, and the National Art Contest featuring works by the Boys and Girls Clubs of South Alabama, of course, including photography. So let's get started with the gallery tour. We start today's tour with Sans Camera Exploring Photograms by Mike Kittrell. Mike Kittrell is a freelance editorial photographer based in Mobile. With a career spanning over 30 years, his work has appeared in national and international publications, as well as in the Mobile Arts Council social media, as we frequently use Mike for headshots and for event photos. He does fantastic work. Non-silver-based processes and pinhole photography are two of his photo-related interests. However, this exhibit features cameraless photograms of botanical, industrial, and household objects using the antique cyanotype photo process from the early 1840s. English scientist and astronomer Sir John Herschel invented the process as a means to reproduce his notes and drawings, hence the invention of the blueprint. Objects depicted in the exhibit were placed in direct contact with watercolor paper hand-coated with iron-based photosensitive chemistry and were exposed using direct sunlight or a UV box. Exposure times ranged from 6 to 12 minutes. The only developing of the exposed image required was a short wash in water to remove excess chemistry, resulting in a white image on a deep blue background. It is a fairly simple and safe process with permanent results. Due to the slowness of the cyanotype chemistry, it's a contact printing process. The blue image color can also be altered by chemical toners or stained by using tea or coffee. Cyanotype chemistry can be applied to a variety of mediums, including paper, fabric, wood, glass, and ceramics. Traditional black and white negatives or enlarged digital negatives can also be printed as cyanotypes when laid directly on the medium. This piece here is a diptych, and it is $300, and all of Mike's works in this exhibition are for sale, and all are reasonably priced. Each framed piece is no more than $200 individually. Some are sold as diptychs, or in the case of Disco Bigfoot, which we're about to come up right here, is sold as five pieces in a set, which I would love to hear the story about Disco Bigfoot from Mike whenever he's got a chance. Featured here is Mike's Bottles and Jars series. The large pieces are each 200, and the smaller, shown in the next section, are 100 each. Now, of course, in addition to creating the cyanotypes, Mike also handcrafted all of his frames, which are an essential part to the complete works. the smaller scale backyard botanicals that Mike has in a large grouping here are each sold separately for $25 a piece. Quarantine Diaries is a group exhibition from photographers with the CameraSouth Photography Club. Each featured image was taken of Mobile since the start of quarantine. The exhibition explores both the constant changes and the screeching halt that the pandemic has brought to us all. CameraSouth is a camera club in Mobile, Alabama that works to provide a platform for people interested in photography. Both professionals and beginners can share ideas, ask questions, and have fun with photography. I would recommend to any photographers in the area that you consider joining their group. They've got a Facebook page, CameraSouth Mobile, Alabama, and if you join their group, they do informative workshops on a regular basis that are a fantastic educational resource. Photographers included in this exhibition are E.J. Wright, John Beatty, Gwen Ainsworth, Debbie Kirkendall, Laurie Scherer, Jennifer Purcell, Ransom Phelps, Carl Follow, Yvonne Follow, Tennille Rim, Eric DeJohn, and Teenie Parker. And last but not least, we have the National Art Contest by the Boys and Girls Clubs of South Alabama. We begin with some paintings courtesy of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Cody Road, as well as the Hope Center Boys and Girls Clubs with this beautiful Africa Town group painting. Next, this wall has lots of paintings courtesy of the Kiwanis Boys and Girls Club.
All of the photography featured in this show is black and white, and it is done by the 21st Century Boys and Girls Clubs in Chestang, Fournier.
A lot of these compositions, especially in the still scenic shots we're about to see, are very well thought out, and we wish all these students the best of luck in the competition. So all of these works featured are the top selections from the Boys and Girls Clubs of South Alabama's recent art competition, showcasing original photography and paintings by local students. The winners of this competition will proceed to the Boys and Girls Club's National Fine Arts Exhibit and Image Makers National Photography Program. Competing within 4 age groups and 18 categories, participants in the National Arts Contest complete original works of art that are exhibited locally, regionally, and nationally. My personal favorite of all of the works in this exhibition are these self-portraits. They're extremely expressive, wonderful use of mixed media, such a variety of techniques and styles. These are all done by students at the Sonny Callahan Boys and Girls Clubs, and they are such fun self-portrait pieces. And that's a wrap for the May 2021 Mobile Arts Council Gallery Tour. Thank you all for joining us, and we hope that you have the chance to come and see the exhibitions in person in our gallery space at 6 South Joachim Street next to the Sanger. Gallery hours are 10 a.m. from 4 p.m., Wednesdays through Fridays, and of course we're open on Art Walk Night until 9 p.m. Come and see us!